Galileo, Kafka, Van Gogh. Some people are just not appreciated until they're gone. Some are so ahead of their time that their craft is simply better suited for a different era. Obviously, in today's video, we're going to talk about one of those cases, Keith Van Horn.
Kittles inside, Van Horn for three, bang! Keith Van Horn from downtown, another clutch fourth quarter bucket, and New Jersey goes up by six.
Drafted second overall out of Utah, just behind Tim Duncan in the 1997 draft, Van Horn was a can't-miss prospect. His career would start off very promising, averaging 19.7 points per game and 6.6 rebounds per game his rookie season, and having his best season in 1999, where he averaged a team-leading 21.8 points per game, 5th overall in the NBA, and 8.5 rebounds per game. However, after his time with the New Jersey Nets, he would find himself a journeyman of the NBA, and would ultimately retire at the young age of 30. He played his final season as the sixth man for the Dallas Mavericks, who fell to the Miami Heat in the 2006 NBA Finals. Van Horn would never see the success he had earlier in his career. So what happened? During the 2002 Eastern Conference Finals versus the Boston Celtics, Van Horn would hit two amazing clutch shots to basically seal the series. However, he would follow that up by getting swept by the Los Angeles Lakers in a series where he'd score no more than six shots in a single game and average only 10.5 points on 38.6% shooting. Post-series, my favorite player of all time, Kenyon Martin, would call out his team saying, "It's the most important game of our lives, and people went out and they just didn't bring it." And this was an obvious call out of Van Horn. And Jason Kidd, the team superstar, co-signed these sentiments. But it was at this point where his career started to decline. Originally with the Nets, he was the best player on a weak team. Once they acquired Jason Kidd for Stephon Marbury, another player who had called him out, his efficiency was expected to skyrocket. However, the team would then draft Kenyon Martin and Richard Jefferson, and these two fit in perfectly with Jason Kidd and coach Byron Scott's Chin Series Princeton offense. After this, he would go on to play with the Sixers, Knicks, Bucks, and Mavs, but never live up to his full potential. But if Keith Van Horn was playing today, I believe he'd have a much greater career. He was listed as a 6'10" power forward, but he was really a giant small forward. He was one of the first big men who could legitimately stretch the floor, knock down threes, and he had a beautiful shot, utilizing great rhythm and even dipping the ball like Klay Thompson or Ray Allen. He could also get you 10 rebounds a night. He fell out of favor in the early 2000s because he was considered a soft big man who couldn't play defense. But make no mistake, he had a solid career. He really only underperformed versus Shaq and Kobe in the Los Angeles Lakers in the NBA Finals. I'd say nowadays he'd be like a Lauri Markkanen type of player. He'd fit in just fine right now, especially with small ball teams like the Rockets, and he could definitely fit in with a lot of teams' defensive standards today. I also think he would do a lot better outside of the Princeton offense that was more suited for Jason Kidd playing off of Kmart and RJ. He would thrive in a more modern positionless read and react spread system. But anyways guys, what do you think? Was Keith Van Horn's game better suited for a different era? Or would he have faced similar problems in today's game? Let us know what you think in the comment section below, and as always, please like, subscribe, and share, and we'll see you on the next one.